This is my Nintendo Switch. I like to play it sometimes, in bursts, and then put it away for a while, usually a few weeks or a couple of months, before coming back again. The problem is the battery goes flat when it's off. I'm not talking about just standby, but completely powered off. This Switch goes flat in just a few days, which is kind of crazy. Now, there were some battery issues with early firmware and battery calibration, but these don't apply when the Switch is completely off. Now, I could leave it in its dock, charging constantly for weeks or even months at a time, but there has to be a better way for occasional use. My plan is to put a small switch inside my Switch to switch the battery to a switched off state. I was thinking about all of this, and then suddenly one day the charger just popped. Smoke came out and I couldn't charge it all anymore. I'm curious to see inside my dead power brick. Now, I've already hit it with a rubber mallet and that's loosened the glue. So we just need to unclip it and have a look inside, because it's starting to separate. All right, there we go. That sounded pretty good. It's coming, one more clip. One more clip and we'll be in. There we go. All right, let's have a look. First, I'm gonna take this shield off.
I broke it open and I found the fuse inside and it was blown. Looking closer at the burn area, there is a toroidal coil that seems to be the cause.
That does not look healthy at all. So this obviously shorted out, took out the fuse. Okay, well, I've satisfied my curiosity with this power supply. I don't know if that'll ever fix it. And I'll put it into a junk box.
I'm just pleased this shoddy thing didn't take out the Switch console itself. I don't know what kind of power supply engineers Nintendo has, but they seem to have failed at doing their job. Nintendo, you're good at making games. How about putting some effort into good power delivery as well? Now that I've replaced the charger, I still need to stop it going flat in a few days when switched off. I found a really small slide switch that should fit somewhere inside.
Probably got a SD card in there. Okay, we're in. Just take that rubber bit out. There we go. Oh, that wasn't hard at all. Completely detached. Okay.
There is this nice gap inside near the battery connector that looks ideal.
And then maybe cut a section out of the casing so I can flip on and off from here and control the battery connection. I've checked continuity on these wires and the two positives are joined together at the battery end and at the switch end. So I'm just going to cut these and join them together through the switch and out again.
I cut the red wires from the battery and put the switch in line.
All right, let's see if we can wire them up to the switch and see what happens. Okay, I've got the switch connected, so I can switch on or off. Now let's see if we can actually plug the battery back in and see what happens. Maybe I should have wired it up slightly differently, because it's not very flexible. Okay, there is the switch close to the position that I'm going to mount it in. But first I'm going to actually charge this up, because it is completely flat. Run some tests and make sure it all works before I mount the switch and start cutting into the casing. But it looks like there'll be enough room.
Next, I had to firmly attach the switch inside. I chose to glue it using a two-part epoxy. Glue isn't necessarily the best choice, but it should be strong enough. The catch is, I have to avoid any glue getting inside the slide switch, or it will just glue up.
So, first I'm actually going to mix the glue. because the glue will take about 10 or 15 minutes to prepare. So may as well do the mixing first. Okay, that's the first mixing. I'll leave that for 10 minutes and then mix it again, and that will give it the best possible strength once it cures fully. I cut the housing away on my console to allow access to the Switch from outside, permanently defacing my Nintendo Switch forever. But in so, extending the life of the battery in this occasional use Switch for a long time to come. Okay, it's cut, I think, at least a millimeter into that housing. Now we'll just remove it, a section for the Switch. There we go. Very slight gap there now. Okay, I've desoldered one of the wires just to make the Switch easier to glue in, and then once it's all together I can resolder. So keep mixing that glue. Throw some glue in there. Put a bit more in there, I think. You need quite a bit of glue to sort of mount the Switch on top of, keep it really stable. So the Switch will just tape it down, but you can see the glue has attached to the Switch. So when I push it down, looks like it's gonna hold the Switch in. It's in the right position, straight enough. I think I'll leave that and see what happens.
A day later, with the glue dried, it was time to reassemble. I'm keen to try this out and see if it worked.
Okay, it's been 24 hours and the glue should have hardened nicely. And that looks all right. I'll put it together and finish modifying the back housing. All right, there's the finished Switch and mounting. That looks all right. I'll put it together. Okay, first up, let's see what we need to do. Okay, there we go. I'm going to need to cut the back of that housing a bit to fit the Switch in. Cut here. And then when the Switch is over there, I'm going to cut here. Okay, I've got two marks on there now, so I know where to cut. I should be able to cut that fairly easily. And something I forgot to consider is the metal shield. That doesn't fit now. I'm going to have to cut a section of the metal shield out. Alright, well that lines up enough. That metal's nice and thin. Okay, that's alright. How's that? That's pretty close. I'm going to have to make sure I insulate the inside of the Switch. Okay, just throw some insulation in there. The silver ones look like they're all pretty much the same size, so they can go in. Okay, done.
So far, so good. My Switch still operates as normal. The big test comes after I put it away for a while with a charged battery. A few weeks later, I switch the battery back on, power up my Switch, and find a battery at 97%. Success. I now have a Switch operating in a much more suitable use case for my style. This is an early model with an exploitable Tegra chip. The other mod I've done is add some homebrew to adjust the color temperature of the screen for a more pleasing night mode. No more glaring blue light blinding me at night. Some other things I'd like to try with the homebrew exploit is overclocking and retro game emulators. And that's my custom modded Nintendo Switch. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.